For the natural look, we're gonna brush the brow up to determine its natural shape. And then we wanna take a little bit of the lightest color and test it for tone through the brow, starting with the light color. She has a little bit of an ash tone brow, so I'm gonna add just a little bit of the second color. And the reason why you'll know this is if it looks at all orangey or too warm in the brow, you know you need to cool it down. And in each pan, I've put in three colors, one warm tone, one neutral tone, and one ash tone. So you can custom blend the color that would be perfect for you. So it's gonna make getting that perfect color foolproof, no problem. And I'm gonna start filling in here very naturally the baseline. Then you're gonna do parallel line on the top and intersect at the end and blend it through. And to get sort of that gradation color where it's where it varies so it looks natural, you wanna have high and low spots. Brush and create the stroke in the direction the hair is growing. So you don't wanna cover the skin completely because then that's gonna be more of a dramatic look. So here we have finished, just brush right through, and here we've finished the natural brow. Then we're gonna use a highlighter right underneath the baseline that I've created and blend and flip to the other side with the shimmer and just add a little shimmer on top. Not very much, just to make it clean and pop. And we're gonna finish it off with a little bit of brow gel. And perfect. Here you have the natural brow. So this is using the convertible, completely dry with the brush as a powder. Okay, so now we have the natural look on both, but we're gonna turn it up. So what's great about the convertible is that it can be used from natural to extreme. So right in the middle is what I call the 3D brow. And I take the BrowGal brush and I spray or dip into a little water. And then I tap on the product itself. It creates a thicker filler that gives me the ability to draw in some hair-like strokes. So this is really great if you have low patches or bald spots, or you're really wanting to build bulk in the brow. So now you can see this started out being her lighter brow. She doesn't have as much hair on her, on this side of her face. And now it's more balanced. And notice we only did the 3D effect on one of her brows. So now we're gonna really turn it up and we're gonna give her that big, full, beautiful pomade brow, AKA the Instagram brow. So all you're gonna do is wet your brush a little bit more. And what you can see is it creates a real thick pomade texture. And we're gonna go back in hair-like strokes and move through the brow. This will give you that full pomade brow. So it converts itself from a powder into a pomade for that very sharp, well-defined look. And after you get it, the depth, the length, and the perfection that you want, you can go in and use your highlighter. We're gonna highlight the more dramatic brow, starting with the matte end first and blending it. You can blend with your finger or your brush. And I'm gonna use more of the shimmer because it gives more of a high-low contrast, which equals more drama. And blend it in and you're gonna get that dramatic pow. You're gonna get that dramatic look near anything. And brush one coat of the gel through the brow. And voila, you're done. Perfect brows. It's easy, super easy.